Hey, dude, what's up? This is Satchel from Steel Panther. You know what you're doing right now? You're watching Loudwire. Ha! So, what was the first thing that inspired me to play guitar? The first riff? A lot of people ask me that, and most of the time I say, I don't know. Like in my 60s now, that was a long, long time ago. Like, I can't even remember what I had for breakfast this morning. You know why? Because I didn't have breakfast, dude. I woke up at 2 in the afternoon. Because I don't have a job, dude. I'm a heavy metal guy. And only people with jobs get up in the morning. Remember that shit. I digress. Let's go back to the riff. I do remember certain riffs inspiring me a lot. Like the first time I ever heard Smoke on the Water. You know, I was a kid. My cousins put on the vinyl. A lot of people have never seen vinyl in this day and age. Put a piece of vinyl on a goddamn record player and put that needle down and turn that motherfucking thing up to 10. And I heard this. It was way cooler sounding though, because I'm playing through an amp the size of a, I don't even know what that, it looks like an iPhone. It's a Fender Champ or some shit. Deep Purple Smoke on the Water, classic shit, okay? I mean, it sounds even better when you got the B3. Who played the B3? John Lord, uh-huh. But Smoke on the Water, classic riff, inspired me to probably pick up the guitar and become a guitar player. Sabbath, by the way. I mean, almost every early Sabbath riff, you know. Now, I gotta say, I knew that Tony Iommi had plastic fingers because he cut the tips of his fingers off. Kids, you know this shit? You know how he did it? Cutting a bagel. It's the most common way. Be careful. Get a bagel cutter, kids. You know, you should know better. You know, don't try to cut a bagel with a knife. You'll cut your goddamn fingers right off. You'll end up like Tony Iommi, which is probably a good thing. Very successful career. Remember that video for Paranoid, huh? I noticed Tony Iommi, he was playing it at the 12th fret. Still sounded great, right? He might have just been f***ing with us because he was like, this is a video, I can do whatever the f*** I want. Just playing the tracks and shit. Were there any other Deep Purple riffs that inspired me? Pretty much all of them, because Richie Blackmore was he's one of my favorite guitar players of all time. And one of the best songwriters of all time. I mean, all the rainbow shit. I don't remember it. All right, it's been a long time. Burn, oh yeah. Great stuff, great stuff. Everything on Machine Head I thought was amazing. His solos are always great, but you know, his songwriting and the arrangements are awesome. Riffage is awesome. If you haven't ever gotten into Deep Purple, it's a treasure trove of awesomeness. It's where a lot of guys were inspired back in the 70s, late 60s, 70s. Richie Blackmore was great. The first riff I ever wrote, the first riff I ever wrote on the guitar, that was back before there was distortion and stuff like that. I can tell you the first riff that I ever wrote for Steel Panther, and that was, I know you're not gonna believe me when I tell you this. It was Death to All But Metal. Of all the songs we've got, what do we got, 70, 100 songs now?
300.
Michael says we have 300 songs now. And that was the first one, and today it's still one of our premier most bitchin' songs. It goes like this. God, that amp sounds pretty good. We should have used that for the record, huh? You know, it's got everything you need to impress your friends at school. The teachers love it. Mom loves it when she's trying to, you know, get you to take the trash out and you got it cranked on your AirPods. AirPods? What the f they called? I don't know. I can't afford them. I'm jealous, all the little kids on the subway and shit. One of the first solos I ever learned was The Last in Line by Dio. You ever heard that shit? Vivian Campbell? In his prime. He was like 14 when he played that shit. Dio snatched him up. He came by. He was actually walking through, I think, where's he from? Ireland, right? Belfast. He lived in Belfast in a small hut. It was a grass hut with a grass roof. And Vivian Campbell was in there, shredding. And that's how he found Vivian Campbell. And he took him away. He abducted him. Didn't even tell his mother. His mom didn't know for like 5 years. His mom didn't know until like years later she picked up a Hit Parader magazine and Vivian was in there and she was like, holy shit, my son's a guitar player for Dio, yeah! But yeah, do you remember the song The Last in Line? Oh yeah. Goosebumps just playing it on this shitty little amp. But I don't even know if I remember the solo, but the solo was, I remember it started like a. So really bitching bends and no choices, and I don't remember. When I was like 12, I had it f***ing nailed, dude. I nailed that shit. I played it at school during the lunch break with my band. Woo! Heavy Metal Rules, the new album by Steel Panther. One of my favorite solos is on the song Heavy Metal Rules. And I love it. I don't even know if I can play it right now because it's so difficult. But I know the first riff goes, like that. The rest of it, it's got all kinds of cool shit. I'm gonna have to relearn it for when we do it, but that solo is one of my favorite solos on the record. The solo for All I Want to Do Is F*** Myself Tonight is another one. Thanks, Michael.
Yeah.
I'm still working on it, but you know what? It's not easy to do through a Fender Champ, kids. Okay, you try that. I like all the solos on our new record because I paid George Lynch a lot of money to do them. Oh, you know what? What other solo I like a lot? There's a song called Let's Get High Tonight. And it's really cool. It's got this very Uli John Roth kind of riff. So it basically does that riff. Really cool, awesome Phrygian, Lydian, mixed Lydian, pentatonic mix. And the kids love that shit in this day and age.